Hatch Files. Fuck me, the things I talk about to you guys. Can you imagine if I spoke about this sort of thing to some guy on the street? He'd be like, what the fuck? Batch Files were awesome. Batch Files were a DOS staple which allowed you to do loads of things. The obvious one was autoexec.bat, which was the batch file which booted on startup. And they allowed you to automate various tasks. So the autoexec.bat, you could load your mouse drivers, you could load your CD-ROM drivers, you could call any programs you wanted to, you could start Windows automatically. So when you had Windows 3.11, Windows 3, Windows 3.1, whatever, you could, instead of booting the DOS, you could put in the batch file the words win and Windows would start up. They were incredible. I use batch files all the time. Games use batch files. Games used to use batch files to load drivers beforehand, to bring up menu system, to bring up interfaces. There was installer batch files. You could use them in Windows, along with PIF files. And PIF files were files which allowed you to configure DOS programs to run correctly on the Windows beforehand. So you'd call the PIF file instead of the program. It would give Windows all the information it needed to run the program successfully. Now, I made various things in batch files. It was like a mini programming language. One of the things was a menu system which used to jump around the screen. So my computer would boot up, it would load all the programs I needed it to, and then it would boot straight into this menu. And from this menu you could pick from an item on the list, say go to Windows, go to Games, and if you pick Games, you'd bring up a submenu, and in that submenu would be all the games I had. And I could press a button, number 3, and it would load Doom, for example, without having to go to DOS and going CD Games, CD Doom and running Doom, which isn't that much hassle, but it was something I copied from school, because school used to have a menu which jumped around the screen. And it jumped around the screen because it was designed to stop screen burn, like screensavers, because early CRT screens, if text was on the same place for too long, the cathode ray tube used to burn the text onto the actual screen itself. So screensavers and things like this jumping menu system prevented that. And, you know, batch files just allowed me to, it was just another area of creative freedom, like the basic programming I spoke about the other day. It was just another area, an extension of that. And I could use it with my basic programs to call things like mouse cursor functionality for my QBasic programs. So there was like a program which gave you cursor functionality in QBasic. So I could write a program and then write a batch file to call it, and then you could run clevcom.bat, which I spoke about last time, and it would launch clevcom with the mouse cursor and anything else, and even like call the QBasic program, because QBasic didn't have a compiler. QuickBasic, the full version, did. You could make an executable file, but QBasic, because it was free, you had to launch your programs from QBasic itself, from the command line. And batch files allowed you to automate all this process and make things much tidier and much neater. So, there's a quick nostalgic discharge on batch files. It just popped into my head. I want to share it with you, so I've shared it with you. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.